One of the most powerful remedies that we have recommended for us here is mentioned in this particular hadith collected by Imam Muslim. This is essential. We have mentioned this in the past, but a lot of people suffer unnecessarily, right? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, has actually gave us something that is proven to work. Now we know that the Quran has therapeutic effect on people. We know this; it's established fact. We know that it brings comfort to the heart and it soothes the soul and relaxes the person and it eases the tension. We know this for sure, right? So it has these benefits, but it also has spiritual benefits that are stated in the hadith, right? We have two types of beings that surround us that we believe in. We may not see them, they're invisible, but very often we feel their presence. Yeah? And they're one group of these beings are called what? Angels. Right? You feel sometimes angelic, right? You feel like you've been touched by an angel. You feel so relaxed. You feel when you're in the presence of people who are acting or behaving in an angelic fashion. The other evil group is called what? The other group that is evil is called the devils. Devils and demons, shayateen. And we know this, right? Has any one of you ever seen a devil? Kinda? Huh? Huh? In a form of human being. Have you seen the effect of the devil? Have you seen the effect of the shayateen? You must have. You have never seen like a sane person, like a nice person, lose it and get angry to the point, if you were to basically record them, if you were to make a video clip of them acting in anger and show it to them, they will say, "Man, I don't know what got into me. I don't know. That's not me." How many times have you heard people saying, "That's not me. I'm not like that." Okay. The Prophet ﷺ said, he told us that this is from the effect of shaitan. And he said that when a person is angry, I know kalima inni a'lamu kalimata law qalaha la dhahaba anhum. That, right? Our households and many people are suffering in their homes because there are a lot of activities and things that we watch and see that invite the shayateen. For instance, and there are certain things that repel and push away angels. Angels are very sensitive beings. They're very gentle, beautiful, pure souls. The place has to be completely pure in order for them to tolerate it. Right? Unfortunately, our households, we have a lot of repellents, angel repellents, things that offend the angels. Yeah, the Prophet said angels are offended by a foul smell. They can't stand it, let alone anything else. Obscene language, that pushes angels away. That's why in our households we can't use this kind of language. The type of language a lot of people use, we can't. You cannot allow that. Angels are offended by that. They just can't. As I said, they're very pure souls, right? Obscene behavior, right? Nudity, etc. There are a lot of things that offend angels, right? On the other hand, there are certain things that invite shayateen. When the Prophet said, when you enter the house, if you don't say assalamu alaikum, you don't mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shayateens are looking for a place to party. So they join this. When we eat or drink and we don't mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's an invitation. That is an implicit invitation. You're saying, "Come join me for the meal." So because of that, one of these remedies, one of these very powerful recommendations, again, this is an authentic hadith. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned the following for those people who feel the effect of it. You don't know why you're agitated. You don't know why when you're at home, you don't feel, because home is supposed to be a place of sukoon and sakina and peace and tranquility and comfort and all of that, but yet we're agitated. Families are running away from each other. We rather like be on our devices distracting each other because we can't stand to have conversations or family time together. right? Everybody's agitated. People get ticked off or angry for like the silliest of reasons. Perhaps maybe it's there are other occupants with us. I don't want to freak you out. I'm not saying, you know, right? And we may need to get rid of them. We don't want them. And the Prophet ﷺ said one of those ways is, the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith collected by Suhail عن أبيه عن أبي هريرة. Abu Huraira said, أنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا تجعلوا بيوتكم مقابر إن الشيطان ينفر من البيت الذي تقرأ فيه سورة البقرة. The Prophet ﷺ said, do not make your houses like graveyards. Shaytan, Satan, runs away from a house in which Surah Al-Baqarah is recited. This is a very explicit, clear hadith. Surah Al-Baqarah, that's why the scholar says Surah Al-Baqarah is supposed to be recited in every Muslim household. It's one thing to listen to it, right? But it's supposed to be recited in every Muslim household. Some scholars say it should be recited at least, if not on a daily basis, once every 3 days. Because there is another hadith that mentions that for 3 days, shaitan will not come near your house. If Surah Al-Baqarah is recited. Surah Al-Baqarah is a very powerful surah. It contains Ayat al-Kursi. Ayat al-Kursi, some scholars said each letter in Ayat al-Kursi, right, has destructive impact on all the evil forces of the devils combined. They cannot overcome one letter, let alone one word. Ayat al-Kursi is the most powerful ayah in the Quran. It has the last two verses, which I recited in the second rak'ah. Amin al-Rasulu. The Prophet ﷺ said, by the way, Ayat al-Kursi, Abu Huraira also was told that if you recite it in the evening, at night, go home right now, you recite it, لا يقربك شيطان, no devil will come near you until the morning. You recite it in the morning, all day you're protected, you're fortified. The last two ayahs of Surah Al-Baqarah, right? The Prophet ﷺ says, من قرأ بالآيتين من سورة البقرة كفتاه. If you read the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, they will suffice you. You're taken care of. So it should be part of our daily practice, ya jama'ah. As I said in the beginning, and I will finish, some people are suffering unnecessarily. There's no need for them to suffer, right? Maybe this is what their soul is actually yearning for. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring comfort and peace and tranquility and serenity in our households, in our hearts, and in our minds. Jazakallah.